he'll get rid of the ball and feed Zegers as Alberti even with the cage on the left. Out of Gary Gait behind. Canaris stops it! Gary Gait leaps over the crease area, stuffs it home. Unbelievable.
All the way over tonight, he'll come in looking for Rome. He's got it. Tonight's got more than 50 goals. Money in the bank.
I think Michael Watson and myself, you know, we came in the same time and started to develop it through our freshman year. Initially, for me in high school, Todd Eckerson, actually, who's an assistant coach at Westminster School, sort of told me about it and saw my style and knew there was, you know, something I was going to need to do to be able to, you know, get in tight and shoot the ball without going to crease every time. So he said, just why don't you leave your feet and score before the ball goes in the net. I remember in practice once, sort of just taking off and leaving my feet and scoring a goal, and everyone was kind of like, what the heck was that? And sort of, you know, from there, a bunch of us started doing it. I played ice hockey my whole life and soccer as well. I think hockey definitely helped me out, you know, with lacrosse, the unorthodox cradling down by my knees a little bit, but it definitely helped me to play lots of different sports growing up. It was pretty cool, actually. You know, they didn't seem to be bothered by it. You know, they were definitely frustrated if I landed in the crease before the goal went in, but, you know, I started to perfect it and it worked out for us. I think it makes the NHL incredibly exciting. I just wish I was young enough to be able to have some of those benefits of being able to do it for a long time. It's pretty cool to watch, definitely. Yeah, it's exciting to watch the highlights or watch a game. My kids get way into it as well. I'm not sure they believe I ever did that, but I try to tell them.